So what we learned was that obesity was a syndrome of multiple pathologies, and that in order to fix any given kid, you had to diagnose the proper pathology. Now, when we did that, kids got better. But the overwhelming majority, it was because of their food. It was because of their ultra-processed food diet.
So how can mitochondria get better for a kid? And can the same healing occur in an older adult, perhaps someone listening to this show?
Absolutely. That's where it's all, what it's all about. So the question is, how do you make new, fresher, better mitochondria?
So is it just, and like cells in your body that are constantly regenerating? We get new mitochondria all the time?
Well, yes. So you have to recycle your mitochondria. So there is a recycling program in your cells, and it is called autophagy, self-eating, autophagy. All of your cells make junk, okay? They make toxic byproducts. And those toxic byproducts can affect proteins, so you get protein aggregation, and now those proteins don't work right. You can get lipid peroxidation, so that those lipids basically become inflammatory. These are all things that have to be cleared. They have to be gotten rid of. So there is a recycling program. It's called ubiquitin. Ubiquitin is a string of amino acids that get put on a protein or a lipid and then get sent to basically the recycling plant of each cell called the proteasome. And it gets cut up into itty bitty pieces and either get recycled into new proteins or get excreted out of the cell entirely. So basically, there is a constant replenishing of the cellular machinery of each of your cells every single day. And it is this process called autophagy. You need autophagy. Autophagy is good. You
and
want
in the
that.
Autophagy of mitochondria that were dysfunctional because of sugar and all the problems you've been talking about, when right. they're chopped up and regenerated, does the the dysfunction carry on into their new constituents, or does it come out fresh?
No, it'll come out fresh, and so the new mitochondria will be good. Will work well until, of course, they go sour also.
So in theory, you just change what you eat, and you could change how your mitochondria function and reduce or completely eliminate metabolic syndrome.
I think completely eliminate. So there are a few things that we know will improve autophagy. One is change your diet. Number two, exercise. Exercise, one of the primary ways it helps is by contributing to autophagy. A third way that Walter Longo at USC showed is intermittent fasting. And so intermittent fasting is a great promoter of autophagy. Number four is reduce stress. Now, good luck with that one. You know, we have a stress-filled world and it ain't getting any better. A fifth one is a compound that we are studying called spermidine. And spermidine is a component of food. It's also made in your cells, and it helps contribute to autophagy. And we're studying a supplement right now to see whether or not it will actually promote autophagy.
So autophagy happens on its own, right? Like, we don't have to do anything. Autophagy is constantly happening.
It's constantly happening, but you can speed it up or slow it down.
Okay. And how does intermittent fasting help mitochondria, autophagy, and metabolic syndrome? What are the mechanics there?
So, intermittent fasting means less food coming into the cell, which means that your ATP is going to be broken up into its components. AMP, which is, and those phosphates, that's liberating the energy to power the cell. Well, when your AMP goes up, that means your ATP went down. And this enzyme I mentioned earlier called AMP kinase senses the increase in AMP. It knows that that means that energy levels are low. And so it then exhibits the then stimulates the program for increased mitochondrial synthesis. So you make more mitochondria, and they're now fresh.
And they're coexisting with unhealthy mitochondria, but the population percentage has changed.
Right.
Yeah.
That's
so,
right.
So this seems to be, at least in theory, a pretty fixable problem. Why have doctors not caught on to this and taken it into practice? And how much nutrition education of what you're telling me today do doctors receive?
So the reason that doctors don't know about it is, number one, there's no pill for that. Number two, there's no ICD-9 or 11 code for that.
What's that?
So when doctors sit down with their patients and evaluate them, they have to generate a billing slip in order to get paid. Okay? And the way you do it is with codes for what was wrong with the patient. Those are called ICD-11 codes. And then codes for what you did, which are called CPT codes. And it is the combination of the ICD-11 code and the CPT code that determines how much Medicare or Medicaid or the insurance company will reimburse the doctor for his or her work.
And sugar is
but
not a
no
box
ICD
that you can
11
check?
Code. No. And autophagy is not a box you can check.
What if it were?
What if it were? We would like that to be.